After a long wait, we finally get to see Starship refueling in space. After much anticipation, Musk has revealed the timeline for this technology, making bold claims that have even surprised NASA, despite recent skepticism. So when can we expect SpaceX to implement this system? What fuels Musk's confidence? Let's discuss it all in today's episode of NR Studio. For many, the idea of refueling in orbit is one of the biggest hurdles facing SpaceX and its Starship initiative. It's an unprecedented undertaking, and the challenge is made even greater by Starship's sheer size. Critics have pointed out the complexities involved, and a prominent voice in this debate has been former NASA Administrator Jim Bridenstine. In a Senate hearing, he expressed significant doubts about Starship's capabilities, questioning the feasibility of orbital refueling. His concerns included the efficiency and reliability of spacecraft launches, as well as whether cryogenic fuel could survive long enough in space to be useful. Unsurprisingly, this statement sparked quite a discussion, and many were eager to hear Musk's response. True to his character, he delivered a short but impactful statement that clarified SpaceX's timeline and affirmed his confidence in the plan. Musk bluntly announced, SpaceX will conduct orbital refueling multiple times next year with Starship V3. This was no longer just a guess or a vague projection. It was a strong promise. He stated that actual orbital refueling operations would begin in 2026. Musk's confidence was based not only on future plans, but also on the recent success of Starship's 10th flight, which addressed many of the issues that plagued the previous V2 mission. The flight also achieved key refueling objectives, such as launching payloads and restarting engines in space. Based on this progress, SpaceX is now ready to move forward with Starship V3. Musk stated that V3 is already in production and will launch later this year, with a firm operational schedule planned for 2026. The upcoming Starship will feature a variety of improvements, from a hot stage and fins to an improved heat shield and Raptor 3 engines. Most importantly, V3 will be larger and have a larger fuel capacity, resulting in improved efficiency in refueling tasks. Even more impressive is Musk's statement that SpaceX will not just attempt a single refueling attempt, but will aim for multiple. This timeline seems logical. V3's maiden flight this year will likely serve as a test platform, with subsequent flights, possibly flights 13 to 15, focusing on recovery operations for both stages. These missions could occur as early as next year. If those flights are successful, orbital refueling could begin as early as mid-2026. This timeline gives SpaceX ample opportunity to build confidence in their new system and master all aspects of launch, recovery, and reuse before focusing on refueling. This is logical, as refueling mechanisms will be crucial for ambitious missions, such as the first uncrewed journey to the Moon or Mars. A crucial question now arises. Is orbital refueling truly feasible? While some critics have cast doubt on the possibility, Musk's answers demonstrate his strong belief in its feasibility. SpaceX is considering two primary strategies. The first strategy involves direct transfer from one spacecraft to another. Here, a fleet of dedicated Starship tankers would be launched to rendezvous with the main Starship in orbit, allowing for the direct transfer of cryogenic fuel. Achieving reliable docking and fuel transfer will be critical, but once the system is proven, the process could be relatively quick. The second strategy focuses on creating an in-orbit storage depot, which would allow for the storage and retrieval of fuel as needed. While this method eases scheduling demands, it presents challenges related to the long-term preservation of cryogenic fuel in space. Both concepts appear extremely difficult. However, Musk insists that both are entirely achievable. He affirmed his belief on Twitter by stating, "Since we're only docking with ourselves, this is a much easier task than docking with the space station, which SpaceX already does several times a year." This statement highlights a significant advantage for SpaceX. Docking two Starships, which use the same systems, hardware, and software, is easier than docking two different spacecraft built by separate organizations. This creates consistency that helps simplify the process. SpaceX has significant experience in docking, as evidenced by its Dragon spacecraft, which routinely transports crew and cargo to the ISS with a perfect success rate. In just a few years, SpaceX has conducted approximately 50 such missions, each requiring precise navigation and synchronization with different systems.
Despite this, each mission has demonstrated smooth and reliable performance. If Dragon can dock with the ISS consistently and safely, it stands to reason that joining two starships, which are designed to work together, will be a much easier task. Musk's statement reinforces his belief. For him, orbital refueling isn't a daunting technical challenge, but rather a natural progression of SpaceX's routinely demonstrated capabilities. The timeline is set and the necessary expertise is already in place. So what do you think? Do you think Musk's confidence is justified? Will SpaceX actually complete multiple orbital refueling by 2026 with Starship V3? Share your thoughts in the comments with a resounding "Let's do it" response. Also, be sure to like this video and subscribe to follow SpaceX's incredible journey to history. Musk's ambitious claims about orbital refueling are not only influencing the discussion around Starship, but also significantly impacting the broader space race.
As mentioned earlier, many individuals, including some within NASA, have expressed skepticism about Starship and its refueling method. Some within the organization have even proposed returning the Artemis program to a conventional approach, based entirely on the Space Launch System, with a smaller role for commercial partners. However, the situation is clear. BSLS faces significant constraints related to cost, progress, and reliability. There are currently substantial concerns about NASA's ability to prepare two rockets, a spacecraft, and a lunar lander in time for Artemis 3 after Artemis 2. The complexity and high cost of this approach make it difficult to maintain it long term. In contrast, although Starship is still in its development phase, it is making rapid progress and demonstrating tremendous potential. Its fully reusable design, high thrust, and rapid production rate offer unique advantages. While orbital refueling presents additional challenges, Musk has consistently asserted that these issues will be resolved. Once achieved, Starship's exceptional lift capacity and flexibility will give NASA a significant advantage in establishing a sustainable presence on the Moon, whether through a surface base or an orbital system. This is why Musk's comments have prompted skeptics to reconsider their views. His refueling assurances have shaped not only public perception, but also internal discussions at NASA. In fact, some leaders at the agency now recognize Starship's promise. For example, Acting Administrator Sean Duffy has expressed hope about Starship's readiness after speaking with SpaceX leaders like Gwynne Shotwell and witnessing the successful 10th flight. He sees the spacecraft gradually proving its capabilities and could play a key role in Artemis 3. These discussions extend beyond the Moon. NASA is also grappling with its Mars sample return initiative, which faces escalating costs, delays, and tremendous complexity. SpaceX's progress with Starship presents an alternative route forward, potentially enabling a faster and more direct mission to Mars. This situation is all the more critical given international competition. China has been rapidly advancing in space, achieving recent successes in lunar exploration, launching new rocket systems, and embarking on ambitious lander missions. Jim Bridenstine has warned that China may overtake the US in the lunar race. These concerns are not unfounded. China's achievements represent consistent progress. The United States risks being left behind if it fails to effectively leverage its commercial collaborators. In this context, Starship's refueling system could be a crucial factor. If proven successful, it would ensure NASA meets its deadlines, strengthen the Artemis program, and accelerate the U.S. journey to Mars. The United States has an opportunity to forge ahead, potentially leaving its competitors behind. Ultimately, collaboration and trust will be crucial. For the U.S. to succeed in these important endeavors, NASA, its partners, and SpaceX must unite behind a shared vision. The refueling concept is a crucial element. It paves the way for humanity's return to the Moon, missions to Mars, and the establishment of permanent space bases. Realizing this ambitious vision requires SpaceX to begin preparations immediately. There is a substantial need for numerous prototypes, which means immediate upgrades and expansion of the production system are required. At the heart of this initiative are the Star Factory and Gigabay, both of which should be fully operational this year or next. These facilities are crucial not only for maintaining production momentum, but also for ensuring Starship's readiness for challenging refueling missions. That's it for today's episode. See you in the next one.